And now we travel to the roadside motel. Oh no, we had to speak to her first, right? Braulio, are you gonna be one of them? Are you gonna be one of them that is never gonna come back?
I couldn't believe it when the name Elena Moore appeared in the Colonel's decoded files. I used to date her sister a few years back. Elena was an annoying 12-year-old who had a knack for entering rooms at the wrong time. It's obvious she still recognizes me when she opens the motel room door.
So you're little Allie Moore, huh? Last time I saw you, you were quite a pest. And you'd just gotten your braces put on, right?
Yeah, but that was quite a while ago, Tex, and I've grown up. You know, I used to have quite a crush on you.
I know, baby.
Yeah,
I know.
I remember. Speaking of crushed, how's your sister? I haven't seen her since our nasty little breakup.
Well, that's
a
lie, Broly.
Years ago.
That's
in
a
fact,
lie,
it was
'cause I've
already
seen you in the
apparent we
stream
get fired
chat
at GRS.
the past 2 weeks.
In
I've
just
seen you.
over a year. Since then, I've worked as Marcus Tucker's personal secretary. He's the director of GRS.
So what does GRS do specifically?
They do genetic research, gene mutations, genetic viruses, that sort of thing. It was very professional, high tech. GRS hired only the best young scientists. But from the beginning, everything seemed really mysterious and secretive.
Is that why you quit?
Here we go.
I didn't leave until I started receiving the threatening notes. At first, I didn't take them seriously, but they kept coming. I decided to get away and use my vacation time. But when I got back,
Don't do it, Diddles!
Someone had gone
I know
from
what
my
you're
apartment.
gonna do!
That's when
Don't
I
do
broke
it!
into this motel.
How did the Colonel find you?
I don't know. He just appeared here one day. It took him a while to convince me that I could trust him. But now, for all I know, he's dead. I'm scared, Tex. Really scared.
Look, I'll do what I can to help you, but I need to know everything. Why do you think someone at GRS wants you out of the way?
I'm not sure. Since I was Mr. Tucker's assistant for a couple years, I had access to most of his files. Maybe someone thinks I saw something I shouldn't have.
Well, since you don't work at GRS anymore, why do you think your life's in danger?
The last day I came to work, I got a note that said my life was in immediate danger. When I saw that someone had broken into my apartment, I knew that I wouldn't be safe anywhere.
Sounds like my next move ought to be to GRS. Can you help me get in?
Yes, I still have a pass key to the main doors. You can take it, but please be
The
careful.
madman did it!
GRS has a 24-hour security watch. With the colonel in the hospital, I have no one to turn to. I don't know if I should, but I'm going to trust you.
I tell Elena to sit tight and wait for me till I get back. I also warn her to keep the door locked and not open it for anyone except me. Elena obviously doesn't know anything more than what she's told me. She's given me the break I need, though, a passkey to GRS. Like the Colonel, I have a feeling that GRS will provide a few answers.
Or death! Alright, we get into the building, and then we're safe again, just to be safe, just to be sure, so we don't have to do all that nonsense again. Don't worry, Scott, I got you, baby.
The GRS office complex is located in the heart of New San Francisco. Elena's passkey gets me into the lobby, which is empty. A directory shows Marcus Tucker's office on the fourth subterranean level.
Fourth?
Take the elevator down. Before the doors open, I hear a warning.
Attention, lethal security probe on premises.
Oh, fuck. Alright. Let's quickly save. The points give us, allow us to buy hints, essentially.
Try to move a little faster this time. If you get out of this alive, do me a favor and start getting some regular exercise. And it wouldn't hurt to lay off the smokes and booze for a while either.
Ah, fuck. Cheese it! Okay, well, at least it didn't actually save me where I was gonna get. Can I be faster, please? I know I can. What are you? Is the thing following me? No. How do I go faster? I don't remember. As long as I don't run into the boss, I'm fine. Oh!
Try to move a little faster this time.
He was in the fucking room! I was bamboozled. Can I just open these?
This access panel appears to be turned off. Getting around this place is too easy.
Alright. I mean, how was I supposed to know the bot was in there? I mean, I could have probably heard it, right? Don't blame the game for my mistakes. I get it. Does that mean the bot's gonna search every room as well? Interesting. What is this?
This computer has a mini disk drive.
Computer passcard required to access this computer.
Alright, so we need a access card. What are you?
This type of safe requires a 6-digit code to open. If the people who worked here are anything like me, they would have written the code somewhere in case they forgot it.
Okay. So now we're on the lookout for a code as well. A 6-digit code, you say? What is the phone number? Or is that crazy? Is that crazy? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
These computer panels probably do something, but I have no idea what it is.
No. I mean, we could check out the other rooms, right? Let's just do that. The bot sounds close. Oh!
Try to move a little faster this time. If you get
fuck
out
off, time. James. Please just open. 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 Ah! Run! Dark, why you gotta be so rude? Right, let's go to research and development and see if we can find the code.
Boy, whoever sat here was really good at tic-tac-toe.
What's up, Snowy? Can I pick that up? No. Visit beautiful Moonchild? Okay. Something on the floor? Span up mine? Try hard. Nice, hex wrench. I'm gonna start beating disrespectful chatters with it. So probably you're up first, mate. Get ready for the beating of your life.
Boy, whoever sat here was really good at tic-tac-toe.
Them again? Can I take the mug?
Judging by the stains in this mug, its owner was a standard bearer for the coffee generation.
What's up, Bray? How are you, buddy?
Looks like this computer requires a computer card to get access to it.
Alright, so then we need another. But his desk has drawers.
Nothing else left in here.
What do you mean? There's clearly paper. I mean.
Nothing else left in here.
Yeah, sure. In before. See? If I look down, I can go supersonic. Let me guess, there's nothing in here?
Nothing else left in here. Nothing else left. Nothing else left in here.
Fuck off. Okay.
Warning. Security sweep will begin in 5 seconds.
Fuck.
Try to move a little.
Oh, for God's sake!
What? Get out of this alive. Do me a.
Jesus, I'm gonna be here for hours. My ranch. Gimme. Oh, for God's sake. How can I hide? There's nowhere to hide. Unless I pretend to be the robot? A robot? Ooh, ooh, oh! Oh, what is this? What?
It's like the TV has no reception capability. It's set up to run only when hooked to a laser disc player.
Between it and the wall? I mean, is that hiding? Laserdisc player. Wasn't this computer a laserdisc player?
Computer passcard required to access this computer.
Yeah, well, I know that woman. Oh my God, there's a free sandwich in there and everything. What if I use the hex wrench on... Okay. And then we use Little Dalton. God, I'm a genius!
Poor little guy. He must have tripped something on the console, or maybe the old roast beef sandwich spontaneously combusted.
Little Dalton is dead! Jesus. What does that say? I'm gonna press it.
That button probably triggers the door.
Oh. Who's gonna be the one to tell him that? He's dead. He died. He died trying to eat a roast beef sandwich, dude. He died the least gangster death of all.
Says Remote Marcus Tucker. This disc was confiscated from Ava Johnson because she was imprisoned on the Moon Child. We are still searching her personal effects for any sign of the winter chip.
Oh, God. Died for a roast beef sandwich.
The consoles seem to be working, but they're inaccessible.
Alright, let's combine. Is that no wacky? It's not funny, it's hilarious. Anyone that dies trying
Warning.
To
Security sweep will begin in 5 seconds.
Well, I'm fucked.
In case you've forgotten, the fourth rule of a PI is don't get caught. The security probe isn't as forgiving as I am.
You get to see him die again. Yeah. No, the mini disc player. I mean, at least it isn't that frustrating, you know? Alright. Well, rip, little buddy. Oh dear.
Poor little guy. He must have tripped something on the console.
His face,
maybe
dude.
The old roast beef sandwich spontaneously combusted.
So you're saying that I can hide behind that partition there? Gimme! Alright.
The console seemed to be working.
So you're saying I can hide here? That doesn't make sense. It's madness. Alright.
Well, that's not gonna work.
Probably need to unlock it first, right? Missing one thing in the R&D room. Okay, let's have another look. What do you mean if I crouch? There's a crouch button? My God. I don't know how to get back up. I don't know how to get back up. This is my life now. Fuck. It's not... why isn't the same... What the fuck? Right. Oh, well, I did not know that. Look at that, me learning things still, how many times? How many hours, should I say? What could I be missing? The papers don't seem to be... doing anything. What?
Let's take a look at this thing. What do we have here? It's like a computer access card.
What the fuck? Yeah, great. Great security work there, guys. Right, so then we use the key card on...
Computer passcard required.
Well, I just gave you one!
This computer...
Hence the use.
Well, that's not gonna work. Well, that's not gonna work.
What do you mean it's not gonna work? It's a computer card. Fuck off.
Well, that's not gonna work. Well, that's not...
Maybe it's a computer in the R&D room? This one.
I should turn on the computer first.
Oh, for God's sake!
Computer passcard required to access this computer. Thank you.
Alright, what are we doing here? Warning, all information. To whoever reads this, the information contained within this file was to be delivered by. Me to Colonel Dobbs. I've been collecting this information over the past 6 weeks. I am now being watched and doubt I'll be able to get in touch with the Colonel. Whoever you are, please get this information to the Colonel. He has promised to take it to the authorities. Okay, The Crusade of Genetic Purity. Soon after I was hired at the GRS, I was asked to submit to a genetic scan When I was found to have no genetic defects, I was invited to join the Crusade for the Genetic Purity. I resisted initially, but accepted when I found out that Eva, she wanted to become a member. Eva is the project supervisor here at GRS. I admit that I had a romantic interest in Eva and thought it would be a way to get to know her. A small group of people met in Marcus Tucker's office after work, and Eva and I were initiated. It didn't take long to realize that this group was not the crusade for the genetic purity. The members called themselves the Brotherhood of Purity, and there were dark rituals and readings of prophecy. Frankly, I was scared, but I was sure that there would be no easy way out once I got involved. It was Eva who told me to contact the Colonel about exposing the Brotherhood. The Enclave? Good God! The project we've been working on is being directed by Mike Tucker with Eva Sheen, Nathaniel Murray, and Camden Linder as project supervisor. Tucker has divided the project. Blah, blah, blah! Racists. What is this? Are we living on the moon or are they shipping? Those that are about the moon child have been told that it's a religious getaway for faithful members of the crusade for genetic purity. I found out otherwise. It was constructed by the leader of the Brotherhood of Purity and is referred to as the Ark of Humanity. The only people allowed to go there are members of the Brotherhood, genetically pure humans. The moon child is gigantic and has been constructed to easily support thousands of people, along with all known forms of animal and plant life for several generations. The ultimate purpose behind the moon child is to provide a safe haven for the faithful while the Earth is going through its final purification. Alright. What else? Secret doctrine. Blah blah blah. Who cares? History? Who cares about that?
Warning. Security?
Oh,
sweet.
Piss off.
Will begin in 5 seconds.
I mean, I'm not dead.
In case you've forgotten, the fourth rule of a PI is done.
The fucking stupid. You look down and you move so fast. It's pissing me off. I can't handle seeing little Dalton die repeatedly.
Let's take a look at this thing.
Jesus. What do you mean, wrong desk? How am I supposed to know which desk to hide behind? There's no clues. Alright. Turn it on.
Computer.
Use the card.
Thank you.
Thank you. You're welcome. Alright, let's just do it so the game knows that I've read this nonsense. The game's very hard, Broly. The game's very hard. Okay, hex wrench, quickly, boom, god damn it. No! There he goes, he just wants a beef sandwich.
Poor little guy. Oh. He must have tripped something on the console, or maybe the old roast beef sandwich spontaneously combusted. At least he got the door open for me.
Go and take the CD. Take the... Let's just travel somewhere safe so we can fucking save. Good grief. Okay. Now we don't have to watch Baby Dalton die again. Okay. Wasn't Kim the lady in the motel room? Right. We're just hide over here. The bot will do go do its thing. Jesus. Run away. Great hint. Great. Glad I wasted my points on that. What? Alright, I think he's just come out.
Looks like Tucker's access panel is turned on. No entry without a passkey.
Try to move a little faster this time. If you get out of this alive, do me a...
It's okay. An evil mansion one, that was what? Phantasmagoria? That was very straightforward. Very straightforward. Alright. I think we already found out a lot about her. Alright, we'll wait for him to come out of the room and then we'll do our thing. Breathe. Deep breaths. Through the... No. What is it? Through the mouth, out the nose? There's got to be a way to disable the bot, I would assume. Alright, is it safe? I don't know. That's a fucking problem.
Looks like Tucker's access panel is turned on. No entry without a passkey. This is...
Alright. What about this one?
This access panel appears to be turned off. Getting around this...
Alright, so we can go in here. Okay. Alright, we have a bit of time. Can we move...
My home movies would look great on that screen. There must be a remote control panel that controls this video screen.
This game came out in 91, I believe, my birth year.
Well, the video screen.
Can I put the disc in?
Well, that's not gonna work.
94. Close enough. Let me tell you, it plays like a game from the 90s. Hello? What have we got here?
Another Playbub magazine.
Playbub.
Say what you will, but I love the articles.
Yeah, I get it for the articles too, my friend. What are you? Oh, is that... What? ...1991. Which, I mean, that's not old!
My home movies would look great on that screen.
Over halfway to 50? Fuck off. The lot of you.
Maybe it's somewhere on the conference table.
Oh yeah, it was on the conference table. Shh. I think the bot's doing its rounds over there, so that should be fine. We should be fine to stay here for a minute. In the high security area. What are the classes a high security area? You're not old, oh, and you're still in your prime? Thanks, man. See? Cool dude's got it. I'm still hippity, alright? I can still hoppity down with the kids. It just sounds like it's getting closer.
Try to move a little faster this time. If you get out of this alive, do me a favor.
Yay! Great audio! Fucking tell where that was coming from. Right, what's a high security area? I don't know. I mean, this looks high security, right? But these drawers don't open.
Just standard office desks.
Yeah, Kim's. She's a granny at this at her age. Are you kidding me?
I love finding unlocked doors.
I don't even. I'm not even old. Oh, fuck off. Fuck off. That's right, I scared him away. I don't want to be young. Yeah, see? Kim's a grandma at her age, like Jesus. How she isn't in the coffin by now, I don't know. Listen, I'm not old. I'm still in my prime. I only make noises when I bend down and pick things up and when I move. Shut up! I hate every one of you. Wrong draw. Alright. No. But oh, and I still look young. So what are you trying to say, Grandma Kim, that I don't?
That door opens into the...
Fuck! I don't think the bot comes in here, so let's save. You said it? No, that's what you're implying! Fuck right off. I'm youthful, damn it. I stay out of the sun.
To access the safe, please prepare for voice ID verification. Please speak your name now.
Hello, I'm Marcus Tucker. Hello, I'm Marcus Tucker. Hello, I'm Marcus Tucker.
Stand by for...
He was
DNA
just flirting.
Scan. DNA incompatible. Attention, security. Intruder on premises.
Run? What's this? Jade?
Looks interesting, but I'll need to find a video cassette player. Let's take a look at this Buddha. Whoops. So clumsy. Well, I'll be darned. This must be the winter chip. And it was right here under the cult's nose the whole time.
Do I need to even be here anymore now?
In case you've forgotten, the fourth...
I'm sorry! I didn't hear any fucking alarm or any... Whoop, whoop, whoop. I'm slowly dying. I'm just wasting away.
Stand by for DNA scan. DNA incompatible. Attention, security. Intruder on premises.
Sure. Right, just quickly grab. Back up. Right. Grab. Grab. Look forward. Look down. Forward. Grab. Leave. Shit. Fuck! I can't stop. Go away! The future of gaming is here. Yeah. Are you kidding me? We'll leave the song requests paused for now. Save. Please just... I'm gonna travel away because... I wanna get somewhere safe. Where I can save. Save? Oh, I can. Go to my office, please. Oh, thank Christ, safe.
I'm glad to be out of GRS. I'll need to catch a few winks before I go anywhere else.
No, save.
First thing in the morning.
No, save. Excuse you? No, save. That's Kim.
There's been a change in plans. You and I have a date.
He's got tinfoil! Run!
It feels like I've been asleep for about 10 seconds when I hear something moving through the office.
It's the Indian cube.
Hello again, Murphy.
Hello.
Remember me?
No.
If not, how about now?
Oh, I've been bamboozled.
The ability to change forms is a talent I was born with. The metamorphosis is difficult to explain, but I've found it quite useful. I haven't had a chance to thank you for your efforts to our cause. You did us a great favor in retrieving the statuette. It was the last key to fulfilling our ancient prophecies. Now we wait until the appointed time. Incidentally, I've kidnapped your girlfriend.
Okay.
I know you're looking for a certain computer chip. I
already got it, so...
Abandon your search now.
I
won't harm Miss Moore.
I mean, I've already got it, so it doesn't matter.
It'd be a shame to kill her.
Yeah, I'd do it.
Besides, it's not easy stuffing a head into one of those water coolers.
I'm sure you'll manage.
Just ask your friend Pug. He's cooling off right now.
Wait. You killed... Oh! That is unsanitary. Who was Pug again? I don't remember. Well,
I tried for an hour to get Pug's head out of the water cooler, but it was no dice. The police showed up and thought about grilling me until they realized Pug was a mutant, and it was like they couldn't care less. That's the trouble with this world. A life's still a life, whether it's mine or Pug's, it still has to count for something. If a crime to humanity is committed, someone should have to pay for it. The chameleon had killed Pug for no good reason and had kidnapped Elena. I'm not about to let him get away with it. Not today.
Oh, we're not? Okay. Let's save. Save 20. 20. Alright. I don't remember who was named after Pug. Alright. I don't think... Well, we'll just go outside. See what happens. My water cooler is gone. Time for sellout? Did you know you get a free subscription with Twitch Prime? Yeah, you can use it on my channel, PogChan. Let's leave. Let's go talk to the woman here.
Talk to me, handsome.
Talking. She wouldn't know anything about the GRS.
Wish I could help you there, Tex.
Alright, I don't even know what I'm supposed to be doing today. Oh, I don't think I actually looked at my... statue.
Let's take a look at this Buddha. Whoops. So clumsy. Well, I'll be darned. This must be the winter chip. And it was right here under the cult's nose the whole time.
We got a video cassette.
That's interesting, but I'll need to find a video cassette player.
A mini disc. So we should go to the electronics store. That would be the first place. Or maybe Tex has got a tape player in his house. I mean, it doesn't look like we can buy anything. But you never know.
Well, what are you looking for?
Do you have fax machines?
Sure do.
I tried.
The Bastion of Sanctuary. Oh god. Oh, Diddles, you missed the most epic of PogChamp content.
I heard that some rich guy a few years back bought the remaining pieces of an ancient European castle. This must be the place. As I approach the coordinates given in the shredded note from GRS, I see a massive structure jutting out from a deeply forested area. The bastion looks like a medieval castle, but there's nothing romantic about this place.
I wish I could see it.
It lay there, a festering evil, like a paper cut gone bad. From here, I can get a good look at the chameleon. He's pacing around, smoking like a brush fire and talking to himself.
Oops. God damn it. Why does it... Huh! Do we want to say hello? Hello, friend?
In case you've forgotten, the fourth rule of a PI.
Let's take a look at this Buddha. I heard that from here I can get a good look at the chameleon. He's pacing around, smoking like a brush fire.
Alright, what can I do here though? Nothing. Can I? What if I don't go into that room? Oh! Oh! Stop it! You're too fast! Jesus. Oh, can I get a suit of armor? PogChamp.
Two antique knives. I'll bet Rook wouldn't mind capturing these. These weapons would be really useful if someone hadn't bolted them to the wall.
Okay. Right. Oh! It goes so fast when I don't want it to. So the point of this is to... How does he not know I'm here?
Well, be darned. That's Uncle Morty, and he was not a handsome man.
Can't do anything to that. But we can go in this door, perhaps? Blood... Is that a door, or was it blood? What is that? Is that a snake?
Well, that's not...
Oh! Fuck these controls.
This door appears to be sealed shut. I guess I'll need to look somewhere else. That's an odd place for a vase. I wonder if I could use it as a distraction.
Interesting. So you got bungee cord... Can we just, like, flick it down?
Well, that's not gonna work.
Bungee cord. Get the gemstone from the piece of art? What, here? Oh, is... For fuck's sake! Stop it! Oh dear. Right, gemstone. Wait, we throw the gemstone at the vase?
Well, that's not gonna work.
What do you mean that's not gonna work? Why? Get the clamp! Alright. So there's clamps around here somewhere? The freaky dude. Well. Hey, what's up, Welshie? How are you, buddy? Enjoying that sweet emote, I see. What am I looking for? A clamp. Oh, there's the clamp right there. Right, so we combine the bungee with the clamp to get a slit. Why don't I just fucking throw the gem? Oh, sure, Broly, I'll stop trolling, yeah. Because it's totally me that does that. Look, you want to see something? Notice how I don't have much control, or it's very slow. But if you ever look slightly down, look how fucking fast you go. It's not me that's doing it. It's this game's momentum, dude. Look, it's all shitty. All right. Now we combine the slingshot with the gemstone. And then we use that on the vase. And now we run. What is that?
Chameleon keeps setting a cigarette in the ashtray. Chameleon has Elena in a laser field. The effect of the beam is probably keeping her sedated. With the chameleon out of the way, I can find out how to shut it off.
Yeah, is he away for long?
That roaring fire makes me wish I'd brought fixins for s'mores.
I don't know, it looks like I can walk into the fire.
Perhaps you're unfamiliar with PI rule number 5.
Yeah, don't question it, Welshie. Don't question it. I mean, that's the question, right? As I don't know how, when I use this on there, quickly look at a hint. Have I still got to search DRS?
Oh, poor guy.
We don't talk about that wrist. Fuck off!
It's the chameleon. Looks like he's enjoying his rich imported cigarette. Maybe I can get him to stop smoking permanently. First, I'll have to create some sort of a smoke screen to get him out of the main room.
So we need to go back to the GRS, okay. It's not my fault it took long. It was a different puzzle. It wasn't all ripped, it was shredded paper, so there was no grooves to go on. It was just words. Alright, what are we doing at GRS? No! What are we doing? We're supervisor's office and find out about Eva. Right. I believe the supervisor was the guy we robbed from.
Try to move a little.
Fuck off! This is the annoying part. It's not a good time. If we just we can hide when we need to.
I'm willing to bet that access to this computer is extremely unlikely.
Anything in the bin? No. So, we're already in there, right? Oh, that's just a hint from not getting caught. Is this not the guy's office? That's a conference room. This is the GRS, the genetic purity nonsense. Oh, all right, we need to get onto this computer, right? But how? It said it needed a key card, but will the chip work on it? I don't know.
Computer pass card required.
Look at it, it was all shredded, alright? It was hard. I mean, this is
a typical fluorescent office lamp.
What do you mean the desk is key? What are you saying? What? Oh! That's so disgustingly sneaky. That's disgusting. I'm disgusted at that. That is... I am not happy about that. I didn't even know you could crouch. That's disgusting. That's disgusting. Alright.
Thank you.
Nothing's coming up. I'll need to load up a disk before I get any information off this computer.
Mini disk.
I've made initial contact with the cult. The colonel's information was right on. There are at least two employees here that are members. I haven't been able to find a solid link between GRS and the cult, but I'm sure Tucker knows what's going on. Over the past month, I've been letting people know that I support the eugenics movement. Finally, I was contacted today by a cult member named Murray. He's a project supervisor. I'll be attending an initiating meeting tomorrow night. I've gotten to know one of the young researchers, Paul Dubois. I'm fairly sure he knows nothing about the cult. He told me that Tucker doesn't trust most of his staff and has the project groups working separately. 9 or 10 people came to the meeting in Tucker's office. The only ones I knew were Tucker, Murray, and Paul. I got the name of only one other cult member, a creepy little Nazi named Camden Leander.
Nazi?
He seemed to be the highest ranking member. I didn't learn much. They seem more concerned with grilling me and Paul. I don't think Paul is cut out for the cult. I think he's a tenant.
We haven't even seen your wrist. Not yet.
I've advised him to get out while he can. Also, there's a young woman named Elena Moore who works as Tucker's assistant. She doesn't seem to know what's going on here. I think she knows too much, and she'll probably be eliminated when the current project is finished. I've warned her to get out of the company. It looks like the project is almost completed. The cult members are ecstatic. I keep hearing them use the words purification and alluvion. I don't know what they mean, but whatever's going to happen is going to happen soon. I'm not going to use a chip until I have a better idea of what they're up to. At our last meeting, there was an older man. He looked familiar, but I couldn't place him. Apparently, he's in charge. I noticed him staring at me during the meetings.
Pug's dead.
Afterwards, he pulled me aside and said there would be a special place for me.
And Dalton Jr.'s dead.
I'm going to play along.
Just so you know, they're both dead now. Alright. Get to the hallway safe. Have we done everything in... I've already been in there, though. What? Dalton Jr. went for a beef sandwich. And died. Right, this is what I want. Is it in this room? Supervisor's office? Oh, it's fucking right there! Oh my... I fucking hate myself sometimes! Okay, how am I gonna get the code for this? God damn it. I've already looked at it.
This type of safe requires a 6-digit code to open. If the people who worked here are anything like me, they would have written the code somewhere in case they forgot it.
Yeah, but they haven't, because I've got my keen eye looking all over the place. And we know it's nowhere obvious. Fuck, I keep doing that. Gimme. Oh, piss off. You know what I'm gonna save? Save 22. Listen, there's nothing wrong with using hints. They're in the game, dude. It's legit. You know, they gave me points to spend. What am I gonna do? Not spend them?
Try to move a little faster.
You know, of course I'm going to spend them.
That door leads.
Shut up, Christopher. There's completely something wrong with that. Oh. I thought I already searched this dude's. Did I search the? I mean, I guess I didn't. I thought I did. A pencil. A match. My match now. Try hard. Well, let me look at it. Jesus.
An old piece of masking tape is stuck here. Looks like some numbers are printed on it. 1-4-2-2-3-5. Probably doesn't mean a thing.
1-4-2-2-3-5. 1-4-2-2-3-5. 1-4-2-2-3-5. 1-4-2-2-3-5. 1-4-2-2-3-5. 1-4-2-2-3-5. 1-4-2-2-3-5. 1-4-2-2-3-5. 1-4-2-2.
Try to move a little faster.
One, four, two, two, three, five. Got him. First try. Didn't even need to go into the dude's op. What is this? Viral powder?
Viral powder for cigarettes? A cigarette load is a classic practical joke, but this is ridiculous.
Alright, let's go get back the... Let's go back and get the match. I can't tell where that sound's coming from. Alright, we go get the match. Then we use the powder on the guy's cigarette? And a chameleon cigarette, and then we kill him? If only that stupid kid didn't steal my gun earlier, life would be a lot easier. Hey, Christopher, because you know my kinky list, I think it's only fair that I know one of your kinks, so if you could just tell me one of your kinks, please, that would be, that'd be great. Alright. Why you? Because I'm more interested in what you got to say than everyone else? Oh, slagged everyone else off! Please don't leave. Because we got a bond. That's why. Because we got a bond. Because we got a bond. Alright, save once more. Save a 23. Alright, inventory combine you and you. Wonderful, wonderful. Can we combine that in a match? No? Okay. Ugh! Oh, fuck. Stop it. Stop it! Stop it! Alright. Let me use this. On that. And now we mess with his cigarette.
Well, that's not gonna work.
No?
Chameleon keeps setting a cigarette in the ashtray.
Match?
Well, that's not gonna work.
What?
Well, that's...
What? Can I...
Well, that's not gonna...
Run. I thought that would be it. I can't even pick up the cigarette there, so...
Perhaps you're
Shut up, James! Come on, Rest, you haven't told me your kink yet.
It's the chameleon. Looks like he's enjoying his rich imported sick.
Oh, those! You want to ride? I'm with you. I've embarrassed myself. No. Combine. Do we dare even light the match? Oh no. Goth slash emo girls. I was kind of hoping for something a bit more juicy. You know, like, I don't know, you like squid tentacles around your anus. For once, Christopher, will you just have a normal thought? For once. Let's do the old switcheroo. Yeah, that is
okay,
more of a
cigarettes in place.
Preference than the kink.
Just go for it. Yeah, here he comes. Come on. Come on. Over to the table for some real smoking enjoyment. He's got it. That's it. Smoke away, sucker. Gotcha.
Thanks, Broly. Oh, what a fool. Smoking will kill
you? Didn't anyone ever tell you these things can kill you?
Uh-huh. Draw me like one of your friends.
I underestimated you, Murphy. Viral powder in my cigarette. Very clever. You're a worthy opponent.
You know, I think the world would be a much nicer place without people like you. People who go around stuffing other people's heads into water coolers.
But you've accomplished nothing. Except now, I'll be a martyr in the new order. And you'll die with all the other vermin. In the great.
He's gonna get so many views. Where's Logan? Put it on YouTube, please.
Has returned to a state of perfection. And the purified races return after the waiting. My name will live forever.
Yeah, I guess that's good in theory. Too bad you won't be around to enjoy it.
Death means nothing.
You sure are living a long time.
A thousand times to help fulfill the sacred prophecy. Enjoy your victory while you can, Murphy. Tomorrow night, you will die.
All right, see you later. excuse you?
I caught a lucky break getting right. Into the chameleon this easy. Death is always an ugly business, but if anyone deserved it, he did. Now I've got to get Elena out of the force field.
Right, out of the force field. I would assume it has something to do with these paintings, right?
Another damn bird. They brought me nothing but bad luck lately. That sun face reminds me of the cute little sun on the Raisin Bran box.
No, she's alive. She's just chilling on the chair.
Thing for mythical beasts.
All right.
Bread, milk, taco sauce. Damn. I know I'm forgetting something.
That's not funny.
This is Peter loaning Paul his Sergeant Pepper's album. I almost bought some chairs just like these at my neighbor's garage sale.
Yes, I did find Behind the Shield, you're right. I'm just looking at the beautiful artwork. Censored! Censored! Where's Jesus when you need him?
I've always enjoyed flipping switches, especially when I'm not absolutely certain what the switch does.
That's right, the new TOS doesn't go into effect until tomorrow. We're safe.
Tex! I knew you'd come!
Yes, it is
that,
me.
That monster came to the motel. He looked just like you.
He's dead.
So I opened the door. He must have knocked me out.
Yes.
It's terrible, the things he said to me. Oh, Tex, hold me. Kiss me.
Kiss her.
Listen, Elena, I'd love to kiss you, but I just had a big chili dog with extra onions. Besides, every time I look at you, I can't help but think of your sister, and that gives me a stomach ache.
But Tex, I think I'm in love with you.
I'll take it where I can get it. Come here, baby. Come here.
Look, I'm sorry, but I've been burned a few too many times. And your sister was a real flamethrower.
Are you sure there's nothing I can do to make you stay?
No, there is.
Do you play Twisty? Ah, never mind. Look, don't get me wrong, Elena. I think you're as cute as a button. But right now, I got a job to do, and I've got to do it alone. Unless I stop the cult from executing their plan, we're all going to be toast.
Men worth having are always running off.
I'll be back.
Maybe it wouldn't work out for us anyway.
Oh, never mind then.
If they don't kill you, let me buy you a drink. I owe you a big one.
Twisty is their version of Twister.
Look, Elena, you don't owe me a thing. But maybe you could help me, because what I really need right now is a good lead.
The Chameleon said that he was supposed to meet up with someone named Feral Puss at a place called the Broken Skull. Does that help?
No.
Yeah, it does.
It does.
He summoned to his presence a thousand hale and light-hearted friends.
James, please.
In the deep seclusion of one of his castellated abbeys.
Now's not the time.
This was an extensive and magnificent structure. The creation of the prince's own eccentric yet august taste. A strong and lofty wall girdled it in. Without was the Red Death.
You lost your echo at the end there, James. What happened?
Is that the final group?
Yes, brother. Everyone has arrived.
And all the provisions are stored. What about the wine? We hadn't received the shipment when I last checked the inventory.
All is in order, brother. We have sufficient supplies to take us into the next century.
Excellent. I will notify the master that everything is prepared. The celebration is set to begin at the appointed hour.
We're going off planet. Fuck it. Can we do that? Okay. Oh, we're driving there, of course. That makes sense. We just drive there. Sure.
The way station is small, with a diameter of maybe 5,000 meters. I have no problem finding the Broken Skull, which turns out to be a typical off-world saloon. The kind of place where all the booze is watered down, the prices are tripled, and the waitresses all have fresh stitches on their foreheads. It's strangely quiet, though, and the dame behind the bar looks like she'd just as soon cut my throat as pour me a drink.
So what'll you have?
Oh my god, who can this be? This can be Fuzzy Otter Balls.
So, what do you got there, sweetheart?
Call me sweetheart again and I'll tear your throat out. Now what do you want?
Uh,
You take out-of-state cash?
We'll take any cash with the Made in the USA logo on it.
Sleazy bribe?
I bet you'd do a lot for $100. Without answering a few questions.
Put your money where your mouth is, Rockefeller.
I have $100, Fuzzy, with your name on it. Take it.
Okay, Moneybags. One question.
Bluffing name dropper?
I'm here to meet someone. The chameleon sent me.
Do you have the token?
Maybe. Give me a hint on the type of token you're looking for.
Wrong answer, friend. I'm afraid that your visit here is going to be permanent.
Fuzzy, no!
I shouldn't have to remind you, Murphy. Never underestimate a woman with an attitude.
Why do all the women I meet try and hurt me? You know? Why? I'm not a bad guy. Come on, rest. Am I a bad guy? Stick up for me, buddy. Oh. At least we know what we're doing, I guess. You use boom, boom,
okay.
Boom, boom.
I caught a lucky
boom, boom. She's whack, get out. Blah, 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 blah. Let's go to my apartment so I can save. I'm not completely horrible. Thanks, Christopher. Thanks, buddy. Appreciate that. Alright, now we save. Okay. Okay, so now we can go back and see Fuzzy. You're a good guy, own the girls. Don't know what they're missing.
The way station is...
Yeah.
I got $100 bill right here. Says you like to talk to strangers.
Are you a cop?
No, I'm no stinking cop. I am a seeker of purity. Will abide no defect in spirit or form.
Yeah, whatever. Do you want a drink? You know, we don't take American Express, cash customers only.
Thought the place looked familiar. I must have seen it in a Visa commercial.
Very amusing. What brought you here?
Looking for some friends of mine who came here a while ago.
A lot of people come and go here.
Yeah.
I bet you'd do a lot for $100. How about answering a few questions?
Put your money where your mouth is, Rockefeller.
There you go, sweet cheeks.
Okay, Moneybags. One question.
Can you help me find a ride to the Moonchild?
Do you have the token?
Maybe. Give me a hint on the type of token you're...
Oh, I fucking fucked it.
I shouldn't have...
I hate myself. I pressed the same one. Like, how does that happen? Take my goddamn money.
Okay.
Let me check. No, I must be in my other overcoat.
Look, I'll give you the benefit of the doubt. I mean, maybe you're one of us and maybe you're just an idiot. Go find your token. If you come back here without it, don't plan on leaving.
Okay. Do I still have to search the GRS? For God's sake, we're going back. For the last time. Hopefully. Leave me alone! I'm not an idiot. Me just not member well.
Some kind of remote. Well, the video.
Please.
Well, that's not gonna work. Well, that's not gonna. Some kind of remote can.
What do you mean, and use? I'm gonna plug it in somewhere, I would assume then.
Well, that's not gonna work.
No. Where is it hooked up to? Is it more crouching nonsense? Bollocks. I think.
Locked.
Why is nothing easy? Just use the chip.
A lot.
What do you mean locked? Does playing the remote unlock it somehow remotely?
Well.
Or is that just crazy?
Locked.
It's a great sound. I love it.
Warning. Security sweep will begin in 5 seconds.
Fuck. We're dead. La da 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 da. If I can't see the security can't see me. Ha ha! I was here the entire time. Okay, any of these paintings move? I mean, there's too, well, pictures. There's too many for them to not move. Really? No. Really?
Tested, mother.
Okay, right. Let's check the drawers again. That was just Playbop.
Playbop magazine. Say what you will, but I love the articles.
Okay, on the desk. On the table. Under the paper. In the coffee cups. On the floor, under the chair, under the table, under the plant pots. Oh, there's a key right there. Huh. That was easy.
I should turn on the VCR.
Oh, for God's sake.
Okay. It's turned on now.
Warning. Security sweep will begin in 5 seconds.
Oh, fucking cheese it! Cheese it, cheese it, cheese it, cheese it. Oh, no, no. Yes, no. Stop moving, stop moving. Okay. Scott! What's one of your kinks, Tell me, entertain me. Let me know. It seems that Rustafa didn't want to play ball earlier. And that's alright. No judgments here. Alright, use...
My home movies would look great on that screen.
Do we not turn it on? Right, it's in. Is it on?
Okay. It's turned on now.
Alright. Broly, you can answer the question too. What's your kink, buddy?
Though not an effective way to infect the mass population, the viral powder combined with tobacco then inhaled is the quickest way to provoke death. Witness its effects on the traitor Paul Dubois.
Oh my god.
On a larger scale, the virus can be introduced
sounds
into
like
the
Gabe
upper
Newell.
Atmosphere by means of dispenser satellites. With proper flight path alignment and a minimum of 100 dispensers, Earth's atmosphere could be thoroughly saturated within 12 hours. Once in the atmosphere, the viral molecules bond to condensing moisture and create a seeding effect. The ensuing rainstorms would bring the virus down to the planet's surface. As we have witnessed, the effect of the virus is almost instantaneous, and the entire fauna population of the Earth should expire within several days at most. While this method of extermination is thorough, its residual effects are significant. The atmosphere will continue to cycle the virus for years until natural decay and filtering cause the viral strain to become a negligible portion of the atmosphere. We estimate that this process will require a minimum of 30 years to complete.
Neat. Scott likes being tied up and Brody likes foot jobs. Wow. Alright, we've done everything, right? That's just all avoiding the security. Finding the token. The roadside motel. Alright, we don't have to come back here ever again, I hope, because this place is fucking awful. Well, she eats ass. Is that good? I don't know.
Did you forget something?
My love.
The chameleon said something about using an old silver dollar as a token. I don't know where you could find one. They're so rare.
Well, that was handy. Thanks very much.
Sorry. I don't know about that. GRS stands for Genetic Research Systems. It's a parent company made up of 6 smaller groups. I worked for Marcus Tucker in GDC, Genetic Disease Control.
A silver dollar, a silver dollar. Where would I get a silver dollar? Why would a rare item be at a pawn shop? That doesn't make any sense. But, fuck it. What is the, there we go. Rook's pawn shop. You didn't know you was gay until your wife stuck a finger in your ass?
What else can I help you with, Murphy?
Excuse you. I need a silver dollar.
Yeah, I've got a couple of old Susan B. Anthony silver dollars in my coin collection. They're pretty expensive, but I guess I do owe you something.
Can I have it?
Yeah, I've got a couple of old...
Do I have it? Is it my inventory? I have it? Oh. Well, that was incredibly easy. Okay.
Did you find what you were looking for?
Sure did, baby.
Yeah. It went through the wash, but I think it'll work.
Well, let's see it.
I don't need to save. Okay. I'm not gonna die.
Okay. Go knock on that door and say Jax or better. The man you need to see is in there.
I walk down a hall and look at the name tag on the door. Barrel Puff. Must be a charming guy. I call out the password and a gravelly grating voice calls loudly for me to come in. As I step into the back room, I'm blasted by an aromatic wave of cigar smoke, alcohol, fish, and body sweat. The combination almost knocks me out. The room is empty except for a bloated hog of a man who seems to be the source of all the foul odors.
Christopher?
I ain't seen you here before. Who the hell are you?
Is that... Does Welshie have a character yet? This could be Reese. Welshie.
Hey, call me whatever you want, but don't call me late for the purification.
You bluff a lot, don't you, Tex? I like that in a man.
You know, Mr. Puss, it's not only rude, but it's also illegal to point a Lester flame rod at a total stranger.
You're not a total stranger. I've been waiting for you for a while now.
Oh, you have?
I thought you was going to come up with that chameleon.
So you're disappointed the chameleon isn't here, huh? Why? Was he your girlfriend?
Ooh. Hell, I ought to blow your head off right now. But I ain't gonna. I like watching you sweat.
You know, I bet you do. Probably makes your own body odor less noticeable.
Watch your mouth, boy, or I'll blow your damn head off.
Jeez.
My boss told me that when you got here, I should take care of you. Now sit down!
Well, great. I'd like a Mai Tai with two umbrellas and a nice plate of those cocktail weenies.
I don't think so. I think you wanted me to slit your throat. But
what?
There ain't no sport in that. So I'm gonna give you a chance to beat the odds.
Thank you.
Oh, I've beaten a few odds in my time.
I'll guarantee you haven't beaten this.
Snow globe? Dragon Balls?
I call it the Farolette table. Three of them balls are hollow, and there's a spy drone in each one. They're little robotic arachnids with nasty stingers.
Well, dare I ask what's in the fourth ball?
Inside that one is part of a ticket to the Moonchild. I'll mix them around. Then you just have to pick the ball with the ticket and open it up. Do that four times, and I'll take you to the Moonchild.
Okay.
Sounds like the old shell game to me.
Close enough. Here's the ball with the ticket. Let's play.
Which one's got the ticket? Which one's got the ticket? All right, chat?
Okay, pick a ball. Any ball.
All right. Keep an eye on it, chat. Where is it? Keep an eye on it. Where is it going? Nobody knows. When's it going to stop? Right. Is it this one? This one? No, it's this one.
Finish up this lousy shell game and let's get on with it.
Thank goodness.
The way station is.
I'm so... The chameleon said something about you.
Shut up, Freeman. I was so confident. How did I fuck it up? I was so confident.
What else can I... Yeah, I've got...
How does that happen? Hmm? How does that happen, chat? I don't understand. Everyone got it right but you? Shut up. I swear, what happened? I got bamboozled.
Did you find...
I'm a friend of the chameleon. He told me to come here and look for a fat pig named Puss.
Well, I'll guarantee.
Well.
Inside that one. Close enough. Here's the ball with the ticket. Let's play.
Alright, everyone. Alright, keep your eye on it.
Okay, pick a ball. Any ball.
Where's it gonna go? Nobody knows. Oh. Where is it? Is it here? Is it here? I wasn't actually looking because I didn't want to get it wrong, so I thought I'll just let chat decide. But now they're all saying not to tell me. Cool. 1 and 4. I think people saying bottom. I hate you all.
Finish up it.
All right, fuck you. I'm gonna pay attention this time. All right, we're off.
Did you?
Alright, fuck off everyone. Yeah. Who knows, it could change!
Beginner's luck. Let's see how you do this time.
Okay.
I guess I need to speed up the balls a little bit.
Yeah, you do. Well, speed them.
For me.
Alright. Well, now I fucking lost it already. Hot diggity.
Lucky today, aren't we? I can't wait to see a spy drone tear your head off. No one's gotten this far before, Murphy. It'd be a real shame if you screwed up now.
Yeah, but I won't, because I'm paying so much attention. I've lost it. Alright, well, I'm at chat's mercy. Once again. I was looking at it so hard. Bottom. Too late! Nice, Scott! My man! My man! My man!
We can't make a deal. I'm taking a few people up to the Moonchild in a couple of hours. You can go with us. I have some business to take care of. Wait at the bar until we leave. Drinks are on me. Be sure to ask for the house special. It's my favorite.
Sit down, brother. Have a drink. It's on the house.
Sure.
Thanks. Make it bourbon neat. So, when we leaving?
Oh, it won't be long now. The purification will be tomorrow at midnight.
Yeah, sounds like fun. By the way, Farrell told me to ask about the house special.
Oh, really? Well, Farrell's always been partial to the house special. Here you go.
This ought to hit the spot. Are you gonna join me?
Oh, no, it's a little strong for me. It's a man's drink.
That's sexist.
So, you're Tex Murphy. Well, we're gonna make your trip as comfortable as possible. Nighty night!
love you, Fuzzy. See you in my dreams.
When I come to, I realize I must be on the Moonchild. Searching my pockets, I find that everything I was carrying has been taken, including the winter chip. Maybe if I'd hidden it, say, in a watch with a secret compartment, the cult might not have found it. Now there's no way for me to stop them.
I see you're back again. This is getting old, Murphy.
Because that was obvious.
Did you find?
Yeah, a lot. I'm a friend of the.
Ha ha!
All right, was it bottom? No, it was top. Top.
Beginner.
Top. Bottom? No. Was it? It was top? Was it middle? And then bottom? Or was it top? Bottom, middle? No, top, top. It was middle?
Damn it! I guess I need to.
And then bottom.
Lucky today, aren't we?
And bottom again. See, I lose it there. I don't...
Damn you, Murphy!
I don't know how you, What if I refuse? No, what if I agree? And then...
Yeah, it sounds like...
By the way...
Oh, really?
Change of heart.
I'd really rather have a few fingers of bourbon.
Try this first. Could make you swear off bourbon.
Oh, I don't have a choice.
So, you're Tex Murphy.
The figure was tall and gaunt, and in the costume and bearing of the stranger neither wit nor propriety existed. There are chords in the hearts of the most reckless which cannot be touched without emotion. Even with the utterly lost, to whom life and death are equally jests, there are matters of which no jest can be made.
Yeah, don't make fun of me, chat.
He must have died and gone to heaven.
That's what they're saying.
I don't think people in heaven have raging hangovers. I must be on the Moonchild. I have to admit, it is incredible. I could get used to living in a place like this. I've never seen anything so beautiful.
Stop it, Tex.
Something's coming this way.
It's the floating cube again. Hello? My first movie effect?
How are you? Mr. Murphy? We'll have no sleeping through the greatest event in the history of the world. I'm so glad you could join us on this sacred day. Maybe you don't recognize me. It has been some time. Lowell Percival, at your service. You did a job for me on Mars a few years back. Cleverness, tenacity, both then and now, have shown me that you belong here. In fact, I need to thank you for securing the statuette for us. A flawless crystal and the symbolic purity of the dove are the foundation of our beliefs. Our sacred text has said that our destiny would be secure only if we had the statuette in our possession. We are deeply in your debt. In an hour or so, we will fulfill an ancient prophecy, specifically, the purification by means of the Great Alluvium. It is a fabulous name for a somewhat nasty process. Those creative minds at GRS worked extra hard for a long time to make our prophecy a reality. It was quite a challenge to come up with a plan that would match the details of the Great Alluvium as it is described in our sacred text. It cost me a fortune.
Oh, this can be,
Everything's prepared.
Has Scott been designated?
I will become the savior of our dying world.
This could be Scott.
The earth has become a rotting shell, inhabited by a mongrel breed of half-humans that infest the pure races with their filthy, mutated genes. Is that to be the fate of mankind?
No, you washed them.
Must be thoroughly cleansed for mankind to be saved. Soon, we'll release the seeds of purification, the Great Alluvium, the baptism of fire, which follows will destroy all life on Earth. But from the ashes will arise a glorious new age. In keeping with the sacred prophecies, we'll wait 40 years here on the Moonchild. Then our genetically pure children will return to a world that, like them, is clean and unspoiled. Though I may not live to see it, I will die peacefully, knowing that I have given mankind...
Get on with it!
I desire fly this away. Moon child to be the Ark of Humanity. But it is also a splendid place to spend the next 40 years.
Uh-huh.
We have it all here. Aquariums, aviaries, zoos with animals of all kinds. Forests, rivers, mountains, nightclubs, ballparks. Everything you could ever want. And the people.
Internet?
Only the creme de la creme. Architects, bankers, doctors, artists, musicians, and a former president. And as for the women, they're all beautiful, intelligent, accomplished. 1,000 men, women, and children, all bound together by belief and purpose, a desire to create a world free of imperfections, a society of harmony, peace, without fear, without crime. Share in our dream, Mr. Murphy. You have less than an hour to decide. I can't allow you to attend the big purification party, but I'll be down to see you right after.
Thank you.
I'm sure you'll agree that your options are limited.
What's that? Don't save after this? Okay.
So, Lol Percival is behind all this.
Shut up, Broly.
It is tempting. Sounds like paradise. And there's probably no way to stop the cult now, so maybe I should just make the best of it. Hold on, Murphy. Don't forget what they've got in mind. They intend to wipe out every person that doesn't have to meet their standards. I wouldn't last very long in a club like this. I could never be part of their brotherhood.
Would you?
I've got to find a way to stop them, but I'm going to need some help. Babe Ashanzi is still alive and I can find her. The two of us might be able to figure something out. Maybe so, it's too late, but I've got to do something.
The reason that you don't want to stop them from killing billions of people is because you might get kicked out afterwards?
I looked through the pockets of my overcoat, but they've taken everything. All I've got left is the watch I found at the Countess Mansion. Could be a lot worse, though. At least they didn't find the winter chip.
I'm sorry, Tex, but you're an awful person. Maybe he does follow after me, then. Alright. Let's go find our friend. Although I'm not already... Is that the man's face on the statue?
Back on Earth, this thing wouldn't last 10 minutes without getting spray painted.
Yes, with a badly drawn cock, I would assume. Because graffiti artists these days... Is that a rake? They don't have the imagination. It's just a spouting penis. Hilarious. Could you just draw Christopher's face? Same thing. What the hell is this? Alright, let's examine just in case.
This is a rugged John Stag harvester rake. It's very solid and heavy. Nice piece of stone. Smooth, shiny, and fits snugly in the palm of my hand. Nice piece of stone. High octane lighter fluid in the point and squirt container. Very convenient.
Can we combine that with the, right, what else? Let's have a look. See, can we move? Or is this just... Alright. Look at it, boys. Earth, isn't it beautiful? Isn't that patch beautiful? Alright. What can I use? How can I MacGyver my way out of this? That looks like something. A piece of flint?
This piece of flint takes me back to my days as the Tenderfoot Scout. We spent hours trying to start a fire so we could heat up our beans and weenies.
That's a good word, weenies. Love it. So you combine those two to make flint and steel sparks. We don't want to set fire to that, I guess. For some reason, That, you remember that Simpsons episode, where, Bart, you don't make friends with salad, you don't make friends with salad. I don't know why this reminded me of it, but it fucking well did. We used to bully a kid in school for eating salad. And we used to do the conga, you don't make friends with salad. I mean, how fucked up is that? Oh, man. It's just like, and the kids will literally pick on you for anything. And I'm picking up someone for eating a salad. Oh, God. Oh. I shouldn't be laughing about it. Next game of this, no hints. I mean, well, the hints are, you know, part of the game, dude. There's a hint button. I'd be silly.
Well, that's not.
Not to use it. Rake leaves. Rake leaves. Is there? Hey, look at that. So we squirt that with fluid? Yes, and then... what's happening? And then we beat him on the head with the rake?
Let me give you a few pointers.
Excuse you?
Setting the leaves on fire was moderately clever, but trying to jump him isn't going to work. You're not faster than a speeding bullet.
What?
I looked through the pockets of my overcoat, but they've taken everything.
For God's sake. How many times can I bloody well die? Yeah, that's a good job I did save. I mean, not like I needed to, but, you know, it's always... Yeah. Good to be cautious. I didn't rake the leaves first? Why would that matter? What, am I raking them away? From the door so I can... Escape? Oh no, dude, that seems like witchery. Oops.
This rock.
Oops. Alright. So use the rake on the leaves first, but why would that make a difference? It didn't look like it made a difference.
Looks like someone didn't get around.
But, sure. Or is it just going to make a bigger fire because I've raked them all together? Excuse you?
What an idiot.
Oh my God, that's so stupid. It's funny, but it's stupid. Let's save again. I would be very surprised if anyone's managed to get to this point in the game and not have, well, have they won't have 610 points. Let me tell you that this is probably like a world record for points. We don't need a gun. Not when you've got these two guns right here. It's muscles, by the way. Surely there's going to be something I can pick up. Oh, a free glass. Nice. Not sure what I'm going to do with that yet. What are you?
This panel door is locked. Locked.
Smash it with the glass!
Well, that's not...
Maybe I'll come back.
This looks like an old-fashioned telephone jack. No, it's a recessed button. I'll need something to reach in.
Use the straw?
Well, that's not gonna...
Whatever. Who needs guns when everyone's stupid in the game? Yeah. Let's just keep going left. Wait. What?
This door looks like it probably opens from the other side.
Oh, of course, examine the glass.
Glass is worthless, but I love flex straws.
You're right. I don't know why I didn't think of that. Listen, as the stream goes on, my brain power just sort of diminishes because I'm too busy there trying to karate chop your nasty trolley comments away, you know? And of course, I'm busy as well fending off the horde of women trying to get at me. Stop it, Suzanne. Stop it. No. Warning, no unauthorized use of downlink module.
Aha. This panel should give me access to the Moonchild's main computer. Hold on, everybody, because it's going to be a bumpy ride.
No, that's true, Scott.
Aha. This panel should give me access to the Moonchild's main computer. Hold on, everybody, because it's going to be a bumpy ride.
Do we put in the chips, then?
Well, that's not gonna...
Oh, do we examine...
That watch's secret compartment may be the safest place for me to hide the winter chip.
Do we get it out? No? Oh, no one believes me about me fending off the women's or the women's... Suzanne! Speak so they know you're real. Sorry, she just stepped on a Lego. But there you go, proof.
Pipe is slim, but it feels pretty solid. Make a nice pry bar.
Okay.
Sounds like the purification party is going on somewhere behind this door.
Don't want to go there. What the hell was that noise? I told you she stepped on a... She stepped on a Lego. It wasn't me, guys. It was Suzanne.
Not the door to the stasis room. Maybe I'll find Sleeping Beauty in there. As I enter the stasis room, I feel like I've stepped into a fairy tale. I'm no Prince Charming, but there's a Sleeping Beauty lying peacefully in a cryonic chamber. It's Ava Shanzi. Boy, do I need to talk to her. As I look around, I spot a console nearby. Looking it over, I figure it must be used to control the cryonic sleep state. If I can resuscitate Ava, maybe we can still stop the cult.
Shut up, Christopher.
I've seen consoles like this before. The four buttons along the top must administer injections. The two slider controls look like they regulate the air temperature and oxygen level inside the cryonic tube. I seem to remember that slider mechanisms like these are really sensitive and need to be moved slowly. Well, first things first, I'll need to turn this thing on.
Okay, alright. Alright, I believe I'm gonna get this puzzle first try.
As I enter, I've seen consoles like this before. The four buttons along the top must administer.
Alright, we're on. Okay, pulse rate, good. Sodium, go!
That yellow warning light doesn't look good. Maybe I should wait a few seconds and see if it goes off before I try anything else.
Have some adrenaline.
Well, how was I supposed to figure out that stupid stasis panel? It's hardly fair to give me only one crack at it.
Well, okay.
As I enter, I've...
Alright. First try.
That yellow warning light doesn't look good. Maybe I should wait a few seconds and see if it goes off before I try anything else.
Sure. Yeah. Oh, I move them up and down. Right. Well, I'm going to turn song request back on for this because I feel like it's going to take a while. So, I'll enable them back. God help us.
I've seen consoles.
So that looks...
Aha, a red light went off in one of those phase one boxes. It must have done something right. Now I've got to get those other boxes to light up.
Okay, so now we move this one up. Okay. Alright, now... Would it be injection time?
That yellow warning light doesn't look good. Maybe I should wait a few seconds and see if it goes off before I try anything else.
Maybe it's adrenaline first. Okay, so then maybe we have to raise the stasis? No, because then that might move, that might turn off the, well, we'll see if it gets rid of the, No. No. Maybe just another dose of the sodium, then. No? It's a terrible thing to lose. Fuck!
As I supposed to figure it. It's a terrible thing to lose.
Alright, well, let's just whack this back on. Oh, okay, so we stay at... Okay. Can we move this? No. Oops. Don't know what happened there.
As I enter this...
What's going on? Where's the next song? There it is. It looks like I can move this, but I don't think I can I? Or is it just...
That yellow warning light doesn't look good. Maybe I should move the slider back to where it was and try again.
Oh god, it won't let me move it! Don't die! I thought you couldn't press it because they're not lit up. Okay, so we can use all the buttons. So, alright. So, phase, that's complete, right? Oops.
What was I supposed to figure out?
Okay, so that should still be, should be on phase 2, right? Yeah. Alright, so then we up. This as well. No.
That yellow warning light doesn't.
Yeah, I know. I know. Right, bring that back down. How a bit of. Okay. Now let's test. No. No. Shock again? No. Oh, my bad. It's fine. She's dead.
How was I? Because I entered.
Okay, so then it has to be adrenaline. And then. Up this? Okay. We got it. What's up, Blue? I mean, this seems to be working so far, so we'll keep... And now, trial and error. Okay. Adrenaline hasn't worked yet, has it? So now it will.
That yellow warning light doesn't look good. Maybe I should wait a few seconds and see if it goes off before I try it.
Because we're at the last second here. We'll just stop the song request for now, and because it's gonna be boom. Do 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 do.
Well, how was I supposed to figure out that stupid?
Do 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 do. Who needs song request when you've got me? Then it's boom. God, we're so good. First try as well.
So is it all over? Prophecy's taken care of?
I'm sorry. Hello?
Look, prophecies aren't my job description, okay? I'm just a humble PI trying to save the world as we know it.
Well, if you're not in the cult, then what are you doing here?
Look, I think we're running out of time here, but my name's Tex Murphy. I know you're Ava Shaanzi because I followed your trail from the Colonel to GRS to
up here.
How you ended up getting freeze-dried?
Percival has a thing for me, so he decided not to have me killed. Instead, he put me into stasis to keep me out of the way until after the purification.
Well, I've got some good news and I've got some bad news. The good news is the purification won't start for about 45 minutes. The bad news is we've only got 45 minutes to stop these people. Luckily, I've got the winter chip, but you need to tell me how to use it.
Well, how did you get it? Listen, there's no time for explanations now. We have to hurry. Take this. There are instructions on.
No, it's got your boob germs on it.
When you get into position, wait for my signal. In exactly 30 minutes, I'm going to create a power surge. That will give us our last chance to stop the cult.
Ugh.
That note also has instructions on how to reach the escape pods. I'll wait until the last second, but hurry. And listen, Murphy, good luck. We get out of here, you can tell me your story.
No, that was very trusting of you. I appreciate that. Oh, you want me to find her number, do you, Kim? I can hook you two lovers up. I don't know who it could be yet. I think we've used everyone in chat. Let's just say it's Phil. You're the second agent aboard. Okay. Get access to level 16 of the Moonchild. There's level chase, blah, blah, blah. Okay, we're already there. Locate and retrieve the link-up computer. Didn't we do that? You would need one of the blah, 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 blah. No, I think everyone that's here has been used. Like the filthy people they are. And that's emergency access.
Looks like the access panel requires some kind of ID badge.
We can perhaps use the pipe to pry the thing in the wherever that observation deck, I think, where we got the glass from. Right, because there was that panel. That. Let's see if we can...
Well, that's not gonna work.
Really?
Well, that's not
smash it!
Well, that's not gonna work.
Oh, that's probably a better idea. Use the actual key on the lock. Yeah. What is this? Golf?
Lynx 986. Looks like some sort of croquet software. Aha! This must be the mini computer.
We just picked. Okay.
Looks like this computer was made specifically to run with a winter chip.
So then we combine that with the winter chip. Okay. And we link it up to this.
Well, that's not gonna work. Well, that's not.
Locate and retrieve the link at computer. Okay, somewhere on level 8 before you discovered. You will need one of the Moonchild's own computer cables in order to attach the link up to the main computer. There is a computer console linked to the Moonchild's main computer hidden somewhere in a wall on this level. Right. So there's a hidden cable. It said on this level, so it doesn't specifically mean this room, right? It could be this room, but it doesn't mean it is this room. Okay. Oh. Let's have a little looky. I mean, it looks. You're saying it is in that room? That's madness. Well, if it's hidden in the wall, then. Can't be that far. So does that mean I gotta like smash Is that because that looks off-colored there? Do I smash, smashy, smashy on the wally wally?
Well, that's not.
I bet the pipe is going to be used for it. Somewhere. Not the wall or the ceiling? Is it on these chairs somewhere?
So these are space-age sofas made from 100% simulated Naugahyde. I guess you have to be practical when furniture has to last 40 years.
Fair enough. At this point, I'm just trolling. Does it look like I'm trolling? Does it? Does it? Why would I do that? Maybe not that one, maybe this one? I mean, that moved way more than I smashed this. And just grab some wires. Absolutely. God, I'm clever. Alright. And we hook this up with the bad boy. You know what? I'm gonna save. Haven't done that in a while. Alright. Save. And then use.
It's been almost 30 minutes. They didn't find Ava. She should be creating a power surge any second. That'll give me time to patch the mini computer into the Moonchild main computer. Now I've got to get to the engineering corridors. And fast.
Oh no, I said 3 frames per second!
I've got a system warning on level 18, section J. I'm attempting to override that. Now I'm showing a temporary system failure. Climate control is down on levels 4 through 18.
Winter sequence engaged.
I don't understand it. The whole system's going haywire.
Why is that even smaller and off-centered? A bit too late. Why is he so happy about that? I mean, why don't you just get to the escape pods like everyone else? Okay, you're dead. There you go, me and Phil, we bang.
Come like a thief in the night, and one by one dropped the revelers, and died each in the despairing posture of his fall. And darkness, and decay, and death held illimitable dominion over all.
That was my chance, James. On the seventh day, I rested.
Ah, you did some good work, Tex.
Thanks.
I guess you didn't forget everything I taught you. Maybe it's not too late. I could make a real detective out of you.
I don't know. The saving the world business doesn't pay so well. My cousin Vinny says he can cut me in on some Amway action.
That's a load of hooey. You got it in your blood, Tex. You'd gumshoe for pocket change.
Hey, pocket change would be a step up for me.
Well, you know, I've done pretty well over the past few years. Put a few greenbacks away. But I'm not so young as I used to be. Maybe we could work out an arrangement, huh? I'll be the brains, you be the legs. A lot of work out there for somebody with your skills. What do you say? Partners?
Nah. Ava. Yeah, I was hoping I'd see you around.
Sup, Phil?
Oh, hi, Tex.
Hello, handsome.
Excuse you?
Long time no see. You look good as ever. What have you been up to?
Nothing much. Say, tell me, have you still got that Twister game?
I do. But I haven't played it in a long time.
Yeah, see you later, Phil. Okay, bye.
Listen, Tex, something's popped up. I think I found a partner to do undercover work with. I'll see you around.
Are you kidding?
I am, back where I started. Lonely, broke, and late for an appointment back in my office. Okay, so maybe it's not a perfect world. Maybe there are more glamorous ways to spend Saturday night than teaching cha-cha lessons to lonely women like Dolores Lightbody. At least she's a regular client, and it seems to make her happy. And she always pays me up front, in cash. Now that I think about it, things are better. I cleared up my bar tab with Louie, and I did solve the pawn shop burglary for Rook. Yeah, once word gets around, I'll be up to my neck in good-paying jobs.
Looks like Murphy pulled it off, sir.
Yes, but next time, he may not be so fortunate.
Next time, sir?
The forces of darkness sleep, but do not die. Even now, I sense evil stirring. An evil about to re-enter the life.
That's my future? A nice girl like this?
Tex, honey!
Ugh.
Long time no see.
What do you want?
Forgive me?
No. Slight overreaction.
One, take one, action.
So you're Tex Murphy. Ah, well, we're gonna make your trip as comfortable as possible. Nighty night.
Perfect. Comes to me.
Okay, the only problem was you don't shoot.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, put that gun away. Fuzzy.
Tomorrow night. You will die.
Okay, good. Oh,
yes. Oscar.
Oscar.
Okay, let's do it one more time.
Typical director. That's perfect. Let's do it one more time.
Let's just...
I can never understand that logic from directors.
Perfect. That's the best I've ever been.
Let's do it one more time.
I mean, I think there's three more Tex Murphy games, so... We got a lot more Tex Murphy to do.
0A1, scene 0A1, take one, action.
Hi, you did some good work, Tex. I guess you didn't forget everything I taught you. Maybe it's not too late, I can make a real detective out of you. That's terrible shit.
Oh, in memory of Jerry. So yeah, we got more text.